I'm Neil Donahue. I'm a professor of chemical engineering, engineering in public policy, and chemistry. And I also direct the Steinbrenner Institute for Environmental Education and Research here at Carnegie Mellon. We study how the chemistry of organic compounds in the atmosphere influences atmospheric aerosols, which are particles suspended in the atmosphere. Organic compounds come from different sources, from human activity and also from the biosphere. From human activity is things like emissions from cars and trucks, smoke from wood fires, also industrial activities, things like the production of metallurgical coke. And in the natural atmosphere, you have compounds that can come off of trees and shrubs and plants and things like that. Aerosols are the largest uncertainty in climate forcing, and climate forcing is how hard humans have pushed on the climate system since the beginning of the industrial era. And aerosols also are a huge source of health effects. More than 1 million people die every year in the world, and more than 50,000 people die in the United States every year because of breathing fine particles. So once these compounds get into the atmosphere, then they get oxidized. Some of those compounds are sticky. They're sticky enough that they can stick to existing particles in the atmosphere, and some of them are so sticky that they can actually form new particles. But if the chemistry goes too far, then the compounds can kind of lose their stick. They break up into really small molecules, and those small molecules aren't sticky anymore. It's kind of like tape that's gone old, and it won't stick to anything anymore. So it's this very dynamic system. We've developed a framework to describe the sticky behavior of organic compounds, which we call volatility, which is being implemented in air quality models and climate models right now. It's already helping to improve the generation of air quality standards to help improve air quality in states and also in the United States in general. And the implementations in climate models are helping to improve our ability to predict these aerosol effects on climate right now.